I'm not being sexist here and introducing all the men first, but that's just how the alphabets have gone. So then we then have Mr. Sebastian. I don't know if his name is really Sebastian or Sabi, but Sabi seems the better way to go. Woo! He's as passionate about food as he is about the captured image. A prolific photographer who deals with the idiosyncrasies of our design professionals every day. A shoot with Sabi is always filled with fun, banter, and witty quips. Has a great eye for detail and believes in finding beauty and not sugarcoating it, sadly for us, or manipulating it to create a visual spectacle. His endeavor is to capture the true essence of a space as it is experienced by a visitor. Thank you, boss. We then have, do you think that due to the extreme sort of exposure to images consistently through all sorts of social media, do we think that architecture or design in general, whether it's product, furniture, graphics, interiors, is more a visual spectacle only, or is there still something more to it?
I think it has to be a combination of both, of the visual spectacle as well as the practicality of a space that sort of inspires and works at the same time.
Of how you see either your projects or even how you experience other people's work, is it more judged by a larger audience just due to the sheer reach, just based on how visually appetizing or appealing it is?
Yes, of course, because that's the first reaction that everybody will have to anything will be first the visual spectacle. So obviously that's going to happen, and it's only once you look beyond it that you need to see deeper into it and experience it rather than just see it.
I cannot disagree with you at all. Being a photographer, I know that the first thing that people want is a good image, and the great lengths to which they can go to ensure that image is perfect. There might be imperfections on the site, but we are asked to cover it up. And that's only because at the end of the day, there is a whole world which is judging you on that one picture. And why should we hide? Today there will be some projects which are judged by other architects, and nobody has visited any of the sites. They're all looking at pictures. So if you do not make that visual count, you're going to be in trouble. It has to, at any given point in time, I believe very strongly, it has to be the first impression that takes it to the next level. Then you experience the project, and then you can say that yes, I mean, what you see and what you experience match.
Experience.
Basically, all these photographers just misguide you, right? Fundamentally.
Jo dikhta hai, wo dikhta hai. Now, let's take example of Ladakh. You've seen visuals of Ladakh. You like those visuals. Now you want to be there and experience it. So what does the visual actually do? It basically sells the idea or the concept or the experience in a different format. Now, when you say Taj Mahal, we have one point. As a photographer, our business is primarily to identify from where does this look really good. Now, as a photographer, I can also tell you, if I don't do visual manipulation, I am true to the space. I have seen it from a point which exists. It's not created. It's not like a 3D render where the wall is not there, they have taken the render from 4 feet behind, and you actually go there, you can't even see that. So, as a photographer, I can tell you that much of what we see in the pictures is true, except that now it is a much more refined aesthetic which is being used to show it to you. Now, if I like a project, I mean, most architects tell me, oh, that project is wonderful, can we visit it? Now, that visit it only came after they saw the pictures.
So, how do you deal with that? Then you go through the process of interpreting that image, and someone else is also reading that separately. So in that sense, it's a very potent technique, that, as I was saying.
When you're framing that shot, right, is it for a target consumer? I mean, when you're doing it professionally, yes. But I'm saying even when you're doing it recreationally, I mean, if you're just doing it because you're traveling or whatever else you're doing it, is there, when you're capturing an image, is it because it got your attention, or is it because you want it to be perceived in a certain way by the viewer?
It depends. If you are called for an assignment, the fundamental intention in that transaction is that we want to see the best view of this particular project. So with all due respect to all photographers, I do not like the idea of digital manipulation. So if there is no sunset there, I would accept the fact that there is no sunset. There is no point in pasting a sunset in a place which does not get sunset. And there are so many mistakes that I see in modern photography because digital manipulation is so easily possible that on the 35th floor of an apartment, they can see the top of a tree. So it's really something which nobody has thought about. If I am ever to shoot a site, or if I have to look at anybody's site for that matter, there are two things. In one of Pranit's site that we shot in Jaipur, there was sunlight which created magic in that space, but at a specific time. Now, as a photographer, I would ask the architect and wait for that time when it is truly magical. Why would I not take that picture? So intention is very clear. That space has the magic. I have just waited for it. But who has done the magic? Not me. It was created by the architect. Now my job is to ensure that that idea which the architect had has to be now put out to the world. That this little jali was to create this magic. I do not want him to cover up some part and open up some part. No, I would not want to agree with that. So it is not to create a spectacle.
Not to put spotlights outside.
Not to put spotlights outside. No lighting comes in extra. It's what is available to you. It's how the way you would stand there and experience it. You try and capture it in a better way because you draw a line, an architect draws a line. It is not meaningless. His line has a meaning. I can draw many meaningless lines. But the same way when I take a picture, I do not want it to be meaningless. So if you call a photographer, it's a different thing. But you can ask a normal guest in that hotel to take a picture. He will take 1,000 pictures from all possible points. They are meaningful to him. I limit at that. The answer is yes. Nobody can deny it. I mean, you want to try as much as you want. It has become a visual spectacle. Everybody is trying to have that Instagram post going. Is trying to put out pictures on Facebook. It's the need of the hour. I mean, today, if you are not there, if you are not seen, you do not exist. To a lot of the people of the next generation, the social media is the only consumption they have. They do not buy books, they do not read. So where do you think they are going to choose an architect or a designer from? It's going to be from the visuals that they swing by every night on Instagram. Now, for the picture to be liked and for you to be followed, there has to be two very important things. Great visual, but also great content. Only then will they follow you. So you have to understand that at the end of the day, today it's a spectacle, but the spectacle is going to die off very soon if you do not have great content. So a great picture which shows great content is the only way you can go forward. 50,000 architects and I have to choose one. Only thing I have, either friend hai, ya discount hai, ya acha kaam hai.
Discount hai.
First say yes and then leave them to practicality. Honestly, I mean, you have to say yes first. Huh? Otherwise, somebody else will do it for you.
No. Let me be true to you. Bullshit. Listen, well, visuals are important. Everybody wants visuals. Everybody wants that perfect Instagrammable spot. But you have to be practical. I mean, come on. I can't give you a chair on one leg which it looks beautiful. I mean, it has to have those qualities.
No, what I'm saying is, you make him sit on a chair with one leg.
No.
And when he tumbles, you tell him they go chart leg.
Put your leg up and say, okay, take a picture now.
No. With this preconceived idea of that space from a particular perspective. Same experience that I didn't talk about, that lobby which has jali and the sunset, sunlight coming through, and it looks magical. And you go to that same space in the morning when the sunlight is not coming through, and you are let down. So the judgment or whatever, the expectations are so high. So we have seen the Taj Mahal in a certain way, and we walk around it and it's not the same. So that's different. Again, it lets you down. Visuals are meant to attract, they are meant to create a kind of communication with you to go and experience it, come by me, whatever message they want to say. But you should not take it seriously. I mean, try video. Because photography has its limitations. We should try video. All the best is go there. So there are spaces like that. There are definitely spaces which you cannot ever capture from the photograph. And it is true on a daily basis for me because the architect has a vision of that space and he keeps telling me, oh, you know, this is a very beautiful space. It is a beautiful space and there's no two ways about it, but it's more experiential. And it's a beautiful space as an experience. But when you try to put a camera and try to take a picture of that, given the different available lights today, all different color temperatures, and the amount of space available to you, the pictures don't do justice. And
yeah, but a lot of us, you know, a lot of us see the image before we see the space. That's why you want to see the space.